Saloon Talk is brought to you by
No Stress, No Memos. But above all, no bad hair days.
Use Radiant Hair Products for a beautiful, natural you.
I have not had this much fun on a show in a very, very long time. My God. So Salongo says the reason why they go for prostitutes is because, I mean, he gets home. He's had a very long day. Akuse, we get it. He's done pedicures and manicures. But he gets there, taps the lady, Nalongo. And she doesn't turn. Tachuk. But the prostitute, you'll find out there like, yo, let's get on with it. She'll take it off and just do a 180. Upside down, and she will be ready, you know. So the truth is, where do we also draw the line with these ladies? Are we saying that all women are prostitutes, like Valentino says, or there are some that are actually prostitutes? And we're also trying to find out why men actually go for prostitutes. So Sheebah, also, while we were off, she mentioned men being prostitutes themselves. Sheebah.
Yes, because we've been talking about only women being prostitutes, yes, which is wrong, because some men are actually prostitutes. Because let's be honest, if you're a man, you dress up well, you just go to silk, to stand in one corner or wink or whatever, you go stand in one corner, dress up nicely, but you're waiting for a cougar to see you and buy you a drink. A cougar who's younger, I could be a cougar because I'm 26, but I'm richer than you. So I could come and...
I'm not sure if you're a man.
You're prostituting.
So when a guy approaches you, does he tell you how much he wants to charge you?
I think yesterday I was home and my friend was telling me she was at the party, and I was like, but I wasn't so shocked because I know them. I've been around, I see guys like them. She was like, we were at the party and then this guy was looking all hot, and then he's all over me asking me, we're buying drinks, we're ordering for wine, whatever, champagne. In my head, I'm thinking, it's his bill. Nigga, after drinking, was like, So, should we add on more? You're a woman. You're no longer a man. That's disgusting. It's embarrassing.
Asa Chichi, what's going on with men? Like, what's going on? Like, I thought you were going there for the sex, but now what's going on?
Now it's more than that. You're even going there for money.
I've never heard of this. I've never seen any male prostitutes.
Valentino has experience here. Valentino, where...
For once, I'll agree with Sheebah. Sheebah Otusi. But the thing is, I personally am not, but I've heard
it's
of
okay,
guys.
It's okay, but it's also fine, Valentino. Life is tight. The economy, inflation, we get
so hard. I work so hard each single day that comes by so that I see that I have a better tomorrow.
Yeah, a better tomorrow could be in a cougar.
The only thing you can buy for a woman is
better. A better tomorrow could be in a cougar with a better money. Better money and better life.
So why do I go on stage to perform?
No. If I'm in a relationship with you, but I'm expecting you, because I remember I had Irene Tally here, she came with a friend, and that lady said that me, when I go to see my boyfriend, when I hang out with him, at the end of the day or the night, he gives me 400,000 Ugandan shillings.
As a must.
Yeah, you know, like, babe, go buy yourself something nice, go get yourself something cool. So, is she a prostitute or not?
Yeah, because...
She is?
You're expecting.
But this is a boyfriend.
No.
What kind of arrangement would happen if that money was taken away?
Yeah.
Please enlighten me. What kind of... it's like me, we know in my management, you have to pay half, 50%, before I come on the show.
We also had Fabiola here, and she said that if she can't sit down with you before, you know, you have to, you know, pay money to sit down with her, and she says even 400,000 is not money. So what is that?
Honestly speaking,
I find that this is the thing.
Anything that has anything to do with cash exchange, you're selling something or planning to sell something. Let's be honest.
No, Sheebah. Okay, so if it's a car, you're not selling.
Honey.
So if I sleep with Arthur expecting that he doesn't have a car, but he'll buy me a vase.
No.
I'm not a prostitute there.
Just to be as plain as it is, as long as you're taking something.
And expecting.
Exactly, that is trade. Honey, it's trade. Yes. So whether you want to sugarcoat it, or I'm classy and all that, it is all the same. You're expecting. So you're selling something. You're selling something.
Wama and Katinawe, let me ask you. Kati, for you, do you think Naboba be about prostitutes if you have a boyfriend nengo suvida ye motoka? Malaya, just kaluba we ya.
That's where it's coming from. When if that money was to be taken away, if wherever we meet,
but then you see, I'm sorry to come in before you answer. Remember that there's also that thing whereby we expect a man to take care of you.
Echo, chengambi chirinti zene Arthur tulifena. Era we know
that we're in a relationship.
To know kubera wo. Na yeah, you don't expect to buenda ba Arthur. Hai no kumpe mtwala na.
No, that's aboy nacho tunda. Yeah, aboy nacho tunda. Once that money goes away, that relationship,
that relationship alters.
It's all because that's what defines that relationship.
Exactly.
It defines that relationship.
Exactly.
We have so many prostitutes in Uganda. My God. So many prostitutes. We are so many prostitutes. We are so many prostitutes.
That's why I said stop looking at prostitution in a negative way.
It could be positive.
It could be positive.
Okay, to wind this down, let's first go to the streets and find out what people have to say. We'll be right back.
If I go there and, they give me something after having sex, that's non-prostitution. He has given me out of love.
I'm a prostitute when I beg him some money.
It's not prostitution because I am his boyfriend, and I know that he has what? The needs or the necessities.
With prostitution, you go with a person whom you don't know, and after you expect the money from that person.
Prostitution, you go with someone, you have sex with the person you don't love, but in return you expect him to pay you. It's like you expect a salary from him.
So King Dider says, hey Judith, you don't know. For a woman, you do how you want with a prostitute, whichever style, for all the time. They are more romantic, and mostly they're always far beautiful than the wife at home.
Ah, marrying someone you do not want in the beginning.
Why are you marrying?
Exactly, it's my point. I said in the beginning, it makes me so mad.
Married men like prostitutes because they never have moods. they're always in their moods. Yeah. Their moods are nice.
Baby men are selfish.
Atakati, baby, why you walk school fees as I would do?
Chokanga school fees as I want now.
Baby, atevin yewa.
You know, and lastly, Fred Samaki says some of them go for prostitutes because they are denied sex by their wives. I guess Sheebah talked about all that. So Valentino, before we go, so you and Cindy, what's going on? why are you laughing?
She's taking the glasses. Yeah, go on.
Well,
I saw it in a tabloid. What's going on? Do you have a thing for her? Because you won't be the only one. DJ Nimrod has a thing for her.
Yeah, the thing is, Cindy is a beautiful lady. Yeah.
What do you like about her most? Is it the legs?
Every man would really love to.
What do you like about her mostly? The legs? Voice?
I love
Nimrod likes the legs.
I love her personality. I love Beyoncé, and she's the Ugandan Beyoncé, you know?
Thank you so much for always showing me love on Saloon Talk, Urban TV. For all those who are always on YouTube looking for the new uploads we've put, thank you so much. The fans in Dubai, fans in Tanzania, Kenya, Rwanda, you guys, I see you. Orlando, thank you so much for the love. Guys, thank you so much for coming. Keep it Urban TV. Next time. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
We're done.
Salon Talk was brought to you by
No Stress, No Memos. But above all, no bad hair days.
Use Radiant Hair Products
for a beautiful natural you.